guys, it's HoppingHammy. Today's video is going to be less of a how to convince your parents for a hamster and more of a how to show your parents you are responsible enough to have one. Many people have asked me how to get their parents to let them have a hamster. Instead of me telling you what I think, I decided to ask my parents firsthand what things might deter them from agreeing. I also asked what things I could do to make them more likely to say yes. Okay, so first of all, you need to be responsible with any current pets that you might own. This was the number one point that both of my parents made during their interview. This means keeping your pet's cage or litter box clean, spending time with them, and showing that they are provided for before even considering adding another pet. It's completely unfair to your current pet or hamster if they need a cage upgrade, for example, but instead you choose to spend the money on a new animal. You should first ensure that your current hamster or pet has all of the necessary supplies that they need. This includes money set aside for a vet fund just in case you should need it in the future. Once they're taken care of, you can then consider adding another hamster to your family. Secondly, your lifestyle and finances play a big part in their decision. Perhaps you're involved in a ton of activities, or maybe you spend every evening out with friends. Whatever the case might be, make sure you have a plan on how to make time for your potential new hamster. This might mean making sacrifices, but it's part of being a responsible pet owner. For finances, how do you plan on paying for your pet? Will your parents be purchasing the necessary supplies? This could be a huge deterrent from making your parents agree. A pet should be your own responsibility. Ask about doing extra chores such as mowing the lawn, vacuuming the house, or washing the car in exchange for supplies. So, let's talk about school and grades right now, okay? This is a very important thing. If you're slacking off in school or getting poor grades, you need to get those grades up before you even think about asking for a pet. Pets can take up precious study time, especially in the evening as hamsters begin to wake up. If motivation is difficult for you, use getting a hamster as an incentive to work harder. Just don't slack off once you do actually get one. Okay, so another factor is space. Do you have the room for another cage without your room looking crowded? Plan out exactly where you will put it and make sure it meets the required minimum for the sake of your hamster. One thing that might help is to show your parents how much you have learned about hamsters. Perhaps you have a hamster binder or a print-off showing proper cages, food, and toys. Make sure your parents understand that this isn't a snap decision and that you plan on providing the best care possible. Be willing to answer their questions or concerns, whether it's who will watch your hamster during family vacation, what happens when you get busy in school, or how you will handle the passing of your hamster when the time comes. It's always good to have a game plan for any issue that could arise. If your parents are still uneasy, give them some time to think about it without pressuring them or sounding like a whiny three-year-old. In the meantime, don't forget to keep your room clean and keep up with your regular chores without being asked. Remember, even if your parents say no for now, it doesn't mean no forever. If your parents say yes, well, that's great. Thank them profusely and make sure you live up to your promises. By keeping your word, it will build the trust and your parents will be more likely to say yes to any other requests in the future. I hope this video has given you tips on how you can show your parents you are responsible. Whether you have a hamster and you want another one, or this will be your first hamster, I wish all of you the best of luck at convincing your parents.